Hi everyone, welcome to UltraFresh Presents Kitchen Bites. I'm Dhruv Trigunayat, the CEO of UltraFresh India. And today I'm joined by four young, exciting minds who are industry experts in their specific fields for a fresh, futuristic and forthcoming chat about all things kitchen.
Hi, I'm Danish Rustam from Welfare Design, and I'd like to thank Dhruv and Pranav for inviting me to this wonderful event of Kitchen Bites.
Hi, I'm Zia Kapadia and I'm an Associate Interior Architect at Newells in Mumbai. Thank you to the UltraFresh team for having me here.
Hi, I'm Pearl Jimmy Mistry and I'm a Director at Della Group. Thank you so much Dhruv and Pranav from the UltraFresh team for inviting me to do this panel today.
Hi, I'm Yasdur Rani and I work with Rustamji. I'm here with UltraFresh today to discuss with other young minds the industry, the technology and the way forward.
When you have so many choices out there, sometimes deciding is little more complicated than what it would have been maybe 20 years back to do your interiors. You didn't have those many options. And so I feel that today there is a lot more technology at use. Like people are trying to, you know, create e-catalogs, they're using virtual reality to be able to visualize the spaces better. There's so much AI being used in, you know, trying to design the spaces. And we are sort of still young and we're trying to talk about the future of the industry. So I think technology is something that we should really be touching on. What would be very exciting for me to know is that in each of our fields or on our projects, how are we using the latest technology that's available? Do we see it in the long term?
Right, so most of our clients aren't, not every client can visualize what design we're pitching to them, right? So, using 3D renders is the best way to go. And also because instead of just showing them one design, I can show them five different designs. And they know exactly what I'm giving them, they know exactly how it's going to look, how the outcome will be.
What about you, Danish?
To be honest with you, I feel it might take a little time to incorporate in Indian spaces because of the volume and because of the, I wouldn't say the demands of the clients. So the thing is, all of these technologies do add certain costs. So when you add up the economics in a certain space, if you have a larger space and if you have a client who genuinely cannot visualize it, then in my eyes it's worthy enough to spend on it. But idealistically, if you see, if the client has a trust in you, that is the initial thing, that he's already seen your work, he knows what kind of things you are presenting to him. So yes, I agree that 3D views over time have become a standard in the industry because the costs have also reduced over time. So when I just started off designing, I remember a 3D view might cost you anywhere between 10,000 to 12,000 rupees per view. But in today's day and age, you find people who are doing it for 3,000 and 4,000 rupees a view.
We do it for free.
Exactly. Yeah. So for that reason, I feel over time, as technology becomes more easily available, it might be more economically viable for people to start spending it as well, whether it's in a luxury home or a corporate space or a residential. Also, I feel VR does help people in actually viewing residences from a far off place. So my client might be from Delhi who's planning to shift to Bombay, and he might get a better aspect or a, you know, presentation than he would probably get even if I showed it to him in person in a 3D view. So I feel it's just a matter of time that we start incorporating all those technologies in our space.
I think that mingling of technology into our industry is going to be a very fascinating thing to see, especially on two points, because first and foremost, obviously it's easier to find and connect with your clients. Spaces become smaller, as you said, my Delhi client can look at my Mumbai site and things like that. But also you can have a much larger catalog and like library online or digitally available than physically. At the same time, what we have seen is that from deciding from an e-catalog in a touch and feel industry for the final decision sometimes doesn't happen. So if I talk to my client, till they see the laminate, till they feel the laminate, they're not going to want to decide it from a screen. Similarly, you know, you had so many of the larger brands that came in with a completely online selling marketplace. But when they realized the interior industry requires a touch and feel, they went into brick and mortar also. So there is going to be like a mix of the two, and that that is something I want to know from Pearl, because I know that Pearl is working on something very exciting online and on a digital platform and using a lot of new technologies available. So I want to know where you see this going.
So Dhruv, I completely agree with you. So at some aspect, while Zia and Danish have a very relevant point that you need to show people things, the virtual medium and the digital platform can just only be a catalyst to speed up the decision-making process. But eventually, especially in the luxury segment, I have two distinct kind of clients. One, like Danish said, they hand you the keys, they leave the entire trust factor on you, they've seen your work, they know your quality.
Best kind of client.
The best kind, the one sent straight from heaven, right? But so with those clients, you discuss it with them, you show them photographs of past work, you show them a little bit of the maybe material and color selection, just so that they have a glance and they're on the same page as you, but they don't dwell into it too much. The other hand, there are clients who, if they've decided they wish to see the final product, I could show them all the renders possible. That's something that we don't like doing though. And instead, we believe in just going ahead and showing them the straight prototype. So it's a lot easier for me, and it's a lot comforting for me, because like the render, with the price ranges and the quality and the duration, it's just faster for me to get this factory to make an immediate prototype sample, show it to them and close it. But the process of reaching to that and doing it much faster is where it kicks in. So even though Della is a very automated and technologically driven company, there's certain things we choose not to do. So now, because coming back to the fact that when you aren't possibly going to be able to stand on a site in Delhi and visualize it, is when you resort to getting a render done. But that being said, we want to give the client all the technological fronting. So you want to put everything automated. So everything in the house is voice automated, whether it's your curtain, your AC, your lights, your kitchen have everything going on. You have your smart TVs located in. You can watch recipes. You can stream things. It's all very friendly. And when you're not using it, it completely blends in with your kitchen. So we're doing all of these things in the final home and the final product. We're also doing it back end for our system processes, billing, accounting. So I think these are just things we assume happen now. So it's no longer taken that, oh, you are on the technological forefront if you're doing this. Right. It's a given and a understood norm. But with rendering and VR and AI, I think we are still going to take time to adapt to it. Not because we don't want to, not because we don't want to invest in it, but because we've understood that the market is not ready to accept it just yet.
So Yazad, like, how has that played in with what you're doing, and you know, how do you see the future of this kind of technology integrating? Because I know that you've worked with some of this to show your flats. I'm sure many people were not visiting the sites at the beginning of lockdown and things like that. So
let me first emphasize on how technology has always been a big part of the Rustomji journey as we've expanded. And I can safely say that that's been one of the really strong points. We take a very, we really believe that technology is important, and it's helped us a lot. So just one example is we've been all on the cloud since about 2006, which was very, for this industry, it's very rare. And Google actually did a case study on us so that other industries could also learn on this. So that idea of technology and implementing that has been, for the last 14, 15 years, a very strong emphasis on how we move forward. But now let's speak of the future, and this is where it gets real interesting. VR and AR and all of these technologies not only are helping us the way we can show customers things, but the coordination from different areas of the world also become easier. So say my windows, I'm getting them from Germany. With BIM and with virtual reality, I can actually go and show them, okay, this is my window size, this is how my the shutter is going to have to be, the distance, the depth. All of these things make the coordination way easier. And it's really amazing if you have actually had the opportunity to go and try one of these things. This technology exists obviously already. And so what I watched is you actually have a layer put on top. So you see everything normal, but it's almost like you have a 3D skeletal superpower. So I get to see the structure, I get to see my beams, I get to understand where my conduiting is, where my AC ducts are, where my plumbing shafts are. It is unbelievable. Because what happens is there's never going to be a problem where my guy who's doing the plumbing versus my guy who's doing the flooring or the construction are not on the same page. And that's why I believe VR and AR is going to come in extremely to change the industry a lot. Focusing on the customer and how we've dealt with technology over there, it's really amazing. Again, if you ever put the headset on, and I've again had a walkthrough of one of these things, It is so detailed, so amazing. The depth, you really do believe that you're sitting in that house. I could be sitting in Hong Kong or Tokyo, and my wife could be sitting in Mumbai trying to purchase an apartment. She can send me that over, I put on my headset, and boom, suddenly I have all the visualization to make a life, a decision that will change my life. A few things that we are looking at Rustomji to talking about technology is we're using a lot of lasers now, like there's something called a LiDAR scanner. Eventually, this is going to, it's a technology where you shoot 1,000 points. Example, in this room, you shoot 1,000 points on the wall, and it will measure those points and actually create a very detailed 3D model. What the brilliance of this is, not only can I check my quality, but I can also pay my contractor or vendor based on the actual work he's done at site. And it's going to increase the speed and the coordination of all of this. And really, it is, I know you believe it's a long time coming, but I feel we are right at the edge of it. This is going to be a change we will all feel, and the customer and the entire industry is going to really love and benefit from all of this stuff.
Any final thoughts, Danish, that you want to leave our viewers with?
I would just say that, given in mind that we have a lot of technology to be used in the future, designing aspect, there is going to be a huge change in the industry in the coming years. So with different vendors, different catalogs getting online, people are shifting more of their module towards a more future ready space. Hence, I feel we should just try sticking to professionals work wise. I think it's a very important thing to do that, and never overcommit yourself is a thing that I've honestly learned over time. And COVID has taught us that very well. If we try and overcommit, and sometimes we do succeed, but when there are certain external factors which cannot help us, I think we should try and stick to undercommitting and basically then
over delivering. Yeah, always.
Correct. So yeah, that's all I'd like
to
share.
What about Zia? Like, any what are your thoughts or like final words on what we've had a discussion about?
Technology is the way to go, I feel. And also when we're talking about modular kitchens and modular furniture in general, I feel like the goal is to complete a work in the most simplest and easy way possible. And that's just any goal that you would have for your client. So
my immediate takeaway from this whole thing would be, and something that I keep consciously telling myself, there is so much happening out there. Like, we just heard about what Rustomji is doing and how they're really reinventing the customer experience and the shopping journey. So either we all immediately start to adapt or we're going to become irrelevant. So that's one. At the same time, really understanding where each of our core competencies lie. Because with so much out there in the market, with so much competition, you either define very clearly what you stand for, what you're good at, what you're offering, or things are going to become very difficult. With technology, it just comes down to really adopting what works for you. If you're going to go and try your hand at everything and not really do a good job and do a shoddy performance at just a few basic things, and you can't keep delivering on it. So like Yazat said, you start off with it in the first go, right? But you don't see that entire thing through, that technology is as good as not using it in the first place, because now you have someone manually doing the whole exercise from the beginning. So I think that understanding needs to be set in place, and where you stand on this and how fast you adopt things that are very relevant and are required is what's going to define your success in the future.
I love that word she used, adaptability. And it's really interesting to see that when you can adapt and you're flexible and you can change, that is really when you will shine, not only as an individual, but as a fraternity or as a company or even as an industry. And why I'm saying this is because we should be flexible, we should be open to change. It's something so important to highlight. And obviously the relationship aspect comes in. You know, Dhruv will tell you 100 times over probably that when selling kitchens, I'm sure he's made them laugh before he makes the sale, because that's when he really gains the trust. And the customer also wants, you see, you're buying into a product, you're buying into his idea and what he wants to present to you. It is a relationship that is so important and so vital. And at the end of the day, all of us over here sitting are dealing with a product that a customer is really going to put a lot of time, money and commitment into it. So I know for a fact all of us have the same view, where the priority here is to just keep the customer happy and make them smile. And with the way forward, with the way we're going, the technology and the way we can adapt, I believe that this is going to be only good things coming to all of us over here.
And I think we are the people who are going to be able to influence the way the industry works in the next 5 to 10 years. And I think it's very important for us to do something like this regularly. I hope for the viewers too, I hope it was at the very least entertaining, but I hope many of you who are involved in the business or looking to renovate your house or looking to buy a new house, I'm sure you would have learned a lot, and I hope you had a good time watching us.